Hi, it's Larry Hryb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show. We're here. We're live. We're on Mixer. We're having a great time. The entire gang is here. Check this out. Let's go. Show everybody. Let's go. Cameraman, show everybody. Two. There we go. Hey.
Hey, everybody.
We've got Jeff Rubenstein down there in the end. Hi, Jeff.
Hi. They love it when you direct the show.
I know. they're fearing me. Next to you, of course, is Laura. Hi, Laura.
Hello. Good to see Laura? Everybody.
And we have sitting with us is Graeme. Graeme and I have done a lot of live shows together. You've heard him on the audio podcast in the past, and now he's here in person.
Yeah. Thanks very much for asking me along.
This is a little bit of fun. You know, this is live, and to be clear, we're it's February 28th. It's 2:01 Pacific. That's 5:01.
They could have staged that.
No, it's I can tell you this is live. I mean, this isn't like a YouTube channel where it's nothing but jump cuts, right? Like back and forth and back and forth and back like that, right? No.
Oh my goodness.
This is real.
Yeah.
This is real. So.
So you can't edit out all the things that I'm not supposed to say.
Precisely.
On the podcast.
Precisely. Okay. We can't. And the one thing we can do, and we have not experimented with this, nor have we talked about this with the crew, is when I realized we were gonna have Graeme, I was like, maybe we should put subtitles because of that accent.
Oh, it's not that bad.
I look at him and I just hear Scrooge McDuck about me money,
no.
Ben.
Oh my God.
I was
looking at you for help and reassurance. Oh. Unbelievable.
There'd be dragons
this is
over
shocking.
Here.
Shocking.
I hear every word you say.
Yeah,
I understand
right,
it.
I knew I could rely on you. You shouldn't be like that.
Thank you, Lassie.
Oh, this is nice, isn't it? Nice setup. You know, usually when I come and do the podcast with you, it's like in a basement.
Yeah, we're actually in a basement.
It is in a basement.
But we've got chat. If you're watching this on Facebook, you're watching this on Twitch, I think you're watching this on, of course, on Mixer. We're giving stuff away in the Mixer chat. Just go to mixer.com/MajorNelson. You can watch the same show there with lower latency. This low latency thing,
if any at all,
is big. Anyway, how you guys doing? We've actually I was on the road. I was at Rare a couple weeks ago. We had Craig. You and I had Craig on the show 2 weeks ago.
It was a good time.
A couple weeks ago.
You know, you've just missed the snowpocalypse in the UK.
Oh, what happened?
It's snowing like everywhere. Like my Twitter today, because obviously I follow a ton of people in the UK.
Right.
Everyone's just telling me that it's snowing.
Okay, well,
if
it's snowing there in the UK, stay inside, stay safe, stay on Xbox Live, watch the stream.
Aberdeen's football match was called off because of the snow, yeah. So that was going to be my lunchtime.
Not anymore.
Not anymore.
Nope.
Yeah, I saw it snowing in London.
Yeah.
And someone actually went to do cross-country skiing in London. Did you see that?
Yeah, I think it was down Old Compton Street in Soho or whatever.
It's pretty funny.
Do you know where that is?
What?
Isn't that where your office used to be down there in Soho?
Originally, back the Xbox in the day? Office way back in the day was in Soho, yeah. But yeah.
And that wraps up London weather.
All right, thank you for that weather. All right, let's talk about
the weather, man.
That's true.
By the way, did anybody find that?
Nobody's going to find that footage.
Community.
It is buried.
So for those of you that don't know, Jeff, in his former life, one of his roles was a weatherman somewhere at a television station here in the U.S.
Is that true?
Yes, and he used to do Mr.
Amazing.
You know the greens. Should we do the weather up here?
Do a lot of this.
Can we bring up the U.S. weather map here? I'd like to see Jeff just kind of walk us through.
I mean, if you want to, there's no microphone.
We'll bring this microphone over and we will hold it.
That's challenge so good. We need to find that. What was your
We're doubling down on weather on this show.
Yeah. Jeff, what was your thing? Because I mean, all weathermen and girls have a thing, right?
Did
you always have a little place you'd refer to, or?
Well, so I would just talk about like what you should be wearing. This was in Florida, so
that narrows it down. Community.
It's basically
Florida.
Flip flops or not? You know, that's one of the. You probably would have guessed that, right? Yeah. The problem is the very first day I took over, like literally my first day. There was a hurricane bearing down on the state. And they were like, cool, you're on for out of the 30 minutes of the newscast. Like, you're on for 14 minutes. Go. And I was like, just board up your windows and run. You know? It's fine.
Run for the hills.
I'm not qualified to be giving you emergency advice. And that holds true to this day.
Okay. Thank you very much for that.
Cool. I'd love to see that.
Well, hopefully the internet will find that clip sometime.
Community out there.
We narrowed it down to Florida.
Yeah. It's Florida.
Yeah.
You
know
weather
more
station.
Than you knew before.
Find the clip for us.
We're going to talk about what we're playing. We've got the console up here. I'm playing a lot of PUBG. Actually, this is. Can we bring the console up here on the screen? Because this is something really disturbing. First of all, I want to welcome everybody who is joining us. People are watching us on the console right now. They can see us right here. We're there with the dog. Do you see the dog?
What?
See, look, we're there, and we're there.
Wow.
What part of the movie are we on now, Larry?
It's Inception.
But here's what's really interesting. I don't know if we can go full screen on this. Did you see the little part that tells you who's ahead of you in Gamerscore? What's going on here?
Yes.
Lollipop is 5 ahead of me. I don't understand this.
Yes.
You need to play and take that back.
How are you ahead of me? What are you? So that's my segue into what are you playing, Laura?
How have you done that?
That's never happened before.
I know. That's why.
How am I ahead of you?
Because you're playing so much PUBG.
There's no achievements.
Yeah, there's no achievements.
So what are you playing? We can dig in. Why don't you talk about it? We'll dig in here.
Yeah, you can probably dig in and see what happened. But I've been busy playing Dance.
Look at that. Look, it's got you with your HoloLens on and your little Xbox, and it's got me with my mean face.
By the way, 15 to 20. This isn't exactly like Stallion 83 here.
That's maybe like one achievement.
But look at this. And now it's here.
Why am I sad? I'm sad because I think it's 42 versus 102.
Oh, I see. So it's an overall.
But you shook it off.
Overall, you're still doing much better.
Well, you're
closing
the gap.
5 points at a time. Oh, my goodness.
By the way, Laura, you might want to play some Overwatch.
Yeah, you're really beating me on the achievements there in Overwatch.
So what are you playing, Laura? This is our segue into the what we're playing section.
Yeah, for sure. So the past couple weeks, I've been off the show. I've been on vacation, but I have had a chance
it holiday.
No, we call it
annual leave.
Yes, thanks very much.
That's what Graeme calls it. I got a chance to dig into Dance Central 3 and get some achievements there. There's a story mode in Dance Central 3 where you are a time traveling dance agent.
Sure.
You know, like you usually are.
Based on a true story.
And mostly. I completed the 80s round.
What was your favorite music? Because, I mean, I love my 80s music.
You do love your 80s
my
music.
My pop sense. So tell me what were you dancing to?
So the goal of the 80s section is to unlock the dance craze of the 80s. And can you guess what the dance...
Break dancing.
Oh, no, my God.
It's not.
The Macarena was the 90s.
That's the 90s. Yeah. That's the 90s.
The Lambada.
No.
What was
any
it?
Any guesses? The electric slide.
Oh.
Electric slide.
That was the 80s. So you have to unlock the electric slide.
Electric slide was early 90s. Can we check?
I think she's right. Look, let's not impugn the good folks at Harmonix.
I mean, look at it. Exactly. So this is you right here, right?
Yeah. That's me. Yeah, you have to play actually that character there in the 80s section. Okay. And the final dance of the 80s section is to nail the electric slide while dancing to Electric Boogie.
Okay.
Cool. At a wedding.
Pretty cool.
I stand corrected. This is 1988. Yeah. When it came out by Mercedes Griffith.
You were already rounding up. Right. You were already living in the 90s.
So you were all about the music.
I was all about
the music. Now, it's interesting. Before I forget, thank you for reminding me. And we'll get back to you in just a second, Laura. Top of the show. Actually, leading into the show, you heard some music. You heard the Halo theme. You heard some Mozart. That was from my personalized playlist that's on Spotify that you can subscribe to. It's music inspired from games. I think the Mozart was some of the music playing in one of the levels of an old Castle Wolfenstein.
Awesome.
Cool. So anyway, that's where I want to make sure I gave my shout out to my friends at Spotify. I'll be updating my list soon. Anyway, Laura, so you're playing dance music. There's some 80s tunes on there.
I would laugh at him, but he's got 5,000 subscribers to that playlist. So
nice work.
Yeah.
You know, people, the hits are the hits. The
like
hits
and subscribe.
Speak for themselves.
There you go.
You could put some Dance Central music on your list.
I can do that.
You could.
Would you help me curate that?
I can.
Laura will help it. So Laura's going to help us curate the next version. Go ahead.
Yeah, for sure.
So
I've got the 90s. Left to do. We started unlocking some of the 90s songs, but that's probably contributing to some of my achievements. But last night, I was scrolling through my hard drive to see if there's any games.
Like you do
on Xbox, see if there's any games that I had downloaded but hadn't had a chance to actually play.
Stack of Shame. The virtual stack
for
of
sure.
Shame. Yes.
And it turns out I had downloaded a game a long time ago called Kingdom New Lands. Have you guys heard of this one?
Yeah.
I think it came out in 2015.
Yeah, it's an old
game. That's just been sitting on my hard drive for forever, not being played. So I wanted to jump in and see what it was like.
Yep.
So it's an 8-bit game. It's an economy building game, and it's completely different than any other economy building game I've played. There's no UI. So you are a person riding on a horse, and you can go left. It's 2D. You can go left
2D
and right.
2D the horse?
No. It's 2D. Two-dimensional.
2D, you know, from the facts of life. 80s.
The horse.
We got all this stuff.
That's your horse's name now is 2D.
That's good. It's a good horse name.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay,
so you ride 2D the horse to build a new...
Here's 2D the horse.
Yeah, great. Yep, there you are. So you're a queen.
This.
You're on a horse. You go left and right, and you build a kingdom. And it's the simplest UI I've ever seen. Simplest interaction model I've ever seen. You just hold the A button. So you can see there that horse is in front of a building, and there's little dots that indicate how much money it costs to upgrade that building, and you've got your little money bag. And so you just hold A, and it puts money in that building, and then the builders come and build it. And then at night, you get attacked by hooligans, I guess it is. So you have to upgrade your defenses and upgrade your armies. But it is really relaxing. I'm glad you're here, Graeme, because I was thinking about you when I was playing this.
Cup of tea?
Because hooligans, it's a cup of tea
hooligan
game.
Part.
Yeah, exactly. I was thinking it's like going to see a football match in back in Scotland.
But
no,
I think
you can have a cup of tea when
it's
you
a cup
do
of tea game because you really only need one hand to play it. Because you just go left and right and the A button. That's all you need.
That's your kind of game.
So it was really relaxing. Yeah. It's got some really good music. The music is what really takes you through the day because you play the day and the night and there's different tracks for the day and the night. So it's really relaxing and it's super fun. So I recommend it if you're looking for a cup of tea game. Maybe give this one a try.
Excellent.
And it comes with Tootie the Horse.
I wish I could Kingdom write it down.
And the achievements. The achievements.
They'll put you ahead of me.
But yeah.
You only need one.
You only
as a couple.
So that's why it's funny because in the we were talking to that was over in the engineering team a couple weeks ago, and I'll talk about that tweet later on. But I was looking at some of the new features, and if you bring up the console here, we were talking about the section here that shows you where you're ahead and who's ahead of you and whatnot. And in this case, you're ahead of me. And I called that the you suck section because it reminds you that you suck because someone's ahead of you all the time.
Yeah.
So that's
maybe it should be who you are ahead of.
Right. Mary. Yeah. Right. Make me feel a little bit better.
Yeah, a little bit
keeps
better.
You grounded, doesn't it?
Maybe there's that. Change it like, do you use Carrot Weather on your phone?
No, what's that?
Oh, Carrot Weather is a weather app that you can get on your phone that you buy and it's got an attitude. It talks. Anyway, so maybe we should set it up so this can have a little bit of attitude with me. But anyway, I digress.
Nice.
You want to feel bad about yourself, follow Stallion83. He's the world gamer score leader. Really good guy. It's the last day of the month, so the gap is as yawning as it will ever get, even though it's February, short month.
Right.
He's 13,660 gamer score ahead of me
good
this
for
month.
Him.
Wow.
It's always good to tell.
So if you want, games.
Yeah, if you want to feel bad about yourself, follow
there we go.
Stallion 83.
Anyway, but here we are. So, Laura, do you have any other games you want to play before we
only
roll?
Other game I've got a chance to check out is Fable Fortune, which came out yesterday.
Yeah.
Was it yesterday? I think I saw you tweet it yesterday or last week.
Yeah.
Earlier. So it's free on Xbox. It's an Xbox Play Anywhere title, so you can play it on Windows 10 as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a card game and set in the Fable universe.
Yep.
So if you like the Fable universe and you want to check out a card game, it's pretty fun.
Here it is. I got it up here on the console right now.
Good.
It's got all your details here, and it's as you said, Laura, it is a card game.
It's free.
Free to play.
Now, do you like those types of card games? Because there's a lot of those types of card games out right now. We can see it right here. And I just didn't know if you were like that Hearthstone kind of.
I'm getting into it. It requires a bunch of strategy, which I really, really enjoy.
Right.
I love strategy games.
It's a beautiful looking game, isn't it?
It's a beautiful game, really well polished. It does take a little while to get into because the strategy is, it's a ramp. Right. And I jumped into the hopper there. You can see it. There's a bunch of training, which is great. You have to go through 3 tutorials to teach you about the mechanics and what makes this game unique from all the other card games out there.
Right.
And I jumped into the multiplayer ring with plenty of experienced people, but I won one, which was great.
Good for
nice.
You.
Well done.
I played 3 games, won one. And there are a bunch of different roles there. You can see some roles there that are starter decks. Like you can be the alchemist, or you can be the knight, which is my favorite at the moment. And there's different cards that come along with that, and different strategies that each of those roles play. So you can try out different roles and find one that suits you. And see if you can win.
Thank you.
They just added achievements to it as well.
Okay. Oh,
so there wasn't achievements when I was playing. I was so upset.
Yeah, well, they just added them.
I think it just like sort of finalized the game. 1.0, it graduated from Xbox Game Preview. And I believe it's an Xbox Game an Xbox Play Anywhere title.
It
so
is.
You
That's
can play
what you
it
said.
If you're more... I was looking at your achievements.
I'm listening, and I'm hosting this thing.
Thank you for listening.
How's the weather, Jeff?
It's live. Yeah.
How's really that weather doing? Run for the
cold
hills,
front coming
everybody.
In
run
that's
for
really
the hills.
Got me distracted.
The achievement names are great as well. We put out a tweet on Xbox. Like we listed some of them, and every single achievement sounds like sort of 80s fantasy metal album or track. So they've done some nice
80s
work there.
Fantasy metal.
My favorite genre.
But I didn't get any achievements, so that didn't sum up to my score, unfortunately.
That's good
to know. I'm looking forward to the achievements.
What are you? Thank you, Laura. What are you playing, Graeme?
Usually, the
story is Graeme always shows up to the podcast incredibly well prepared with a notebook, and he has nothing. If you look here, you'll see nothing. He's got a glass.
Flying blind. Yes. I always panic when I don't have my little notebook with me.
I've got your achievements up here.
That'll help. Because I've been dipping in and out of a lot of stuff over the past month, and the thing that's been on the most has been Disney Infinity. like a bit of a throwback because the boys have been on school holiday.
Yeah.
And they discovered our massive stash of Disney Infinity characters.
Have you been collecting?
Well, yeah. I mean, we were mad about Disney Infinity, and then, you know, it's no longer. God rest
their
soul.
They're collector items.
Yeah, they really genuinely are. I'll
take that.
So, oh, thanks, mate. So, yeah, we've had that on a lot, and I really miss that game. That was a beautiful game, and all the figures are great and stuff. Yeah. So we've had that on. Crackdown?
Yeah, I did a little co-op of that last night. Crackdown is now 4K-ified.
Yes.
It looks phenomenal. Jeffrey, Laura, we should try this.
Yeah.
Is it Crackdown 1?
Crackdown 1, yep.
Crackdown 3.
So now Crackdown 1.
Okay.
Crackdown 1, back compatible, and it's enhanced for X as well.
That's
so it looks absolutely amazing.
Awesome.
Yeah. And,
looks mad.
And that game is just, you know, so many fond memories. Do you know when that game came out?
It came out in time for, well, you remember.
February 20th, 2007.
Wow.
I just
remember
over 11 years ago.
Anniversary.
Yeah.
11 years.
11 years.
That's crazy.
That makes me feel so old.
I just remember it coming out with, and I was a media gentleman at that time, and it came out as
a media gentleman.
Yeah, I was a gentleman in the media.
I can confirm. I can confirm.
Top hat.
Actually, I met you in 2007 for the first time.
That's right.
It was. It came with a beta or a demo for Halo 3. And so
right.
I remember that getting announced. I was like, oh, they must have, there's probably no confidence in this Crackdown game. Everyone's going to get it just to play Halo,
yes,
the Halo 3
that.
Demo.
Mm-hmm. Remember and that,
Laura? Yes, I do.
Could not have been more
started.
Wrong about that. Yeah, because the game itself was amazing. And I remember writing an article to the effect of if you must, buy it for the Halo 3 access, but stay for the Crackdown.
Well, see, it's so funny that you say this because...
Look at this game. It looks so good.
I had only been at Xbox for maybe 6 months when it came out.
That's right.
And that is actually my memory.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think... I remember, you know, I was obviously in the European office. I don't know what it was like over here, but we were approaching it at the time kind of like a way to get the Halo beta out.
Yeah.
And we were we didn't have high hopes for it. And then we saw the reviews start to come in, and I got my copy on launch day and was playing it. I was like, this game is amazing.
Yeah,
and I was obsessed with it for months after.
Yeah, of course, E, who's in the show for many years, he was orb hunting. If you go to my blog at majornelson.com, I've got a post up there from 10 years ago, 11 years ago, with I got the original source file.
I remember this, yeah.
Of the orb sound, and you're welcome to download that and make it into a ringtone or what have you.
So
your text
notifications, textual.
It was great to fire that up again. Of course, born in Scotland.
That's
just
right.
Like
you
me. Have to like it.
Yes,
so, you know,
right.
Also amazing.
That's right.
So, yeah, happy days. It was nice to get back into Crackdown.
I think Crackdown, looking at Crackdown, I think it's aging a little bit better.
Yeah.
Than you.
Thanks very much.
Oh, wow. Larry.
Can we look at, Crackdown
wow.
2007, Crackdown 2018. We should do the gram.
To be honest,
screen.
I wasn't at peak of my physical fitness in 2007.
You're right.
So I think I might look better now than I did then. I was a bigger boy back then.
Anyway.
But it does look great. And the thing, I was looking at some screenshots. I took some screenshots last night. Because it's been up-resed for X,
right.
It's got all the neon, right, at night.
Yeah.
All the neon now looks so sharp. It's got a really cool Blade Runner kind of cyberpunk vibe that I don't really remember.
You
from
don't. Well,
before.
I think it's may not have been playing on an HD.
Yeah, because back in the day, it wasn't much HD.
Right.
Yeah. You were
right.
Probably playing
and it was
on
all
a
diffused
CRT.
And kind of like a bit, you know.
You were playing on a
cloudier.
TV with wood paneling on it.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, hitting the
clunk, clunk. Got the RF switch turned to channel 2 in the back, maybe 3.
There you go.
Yenzer, who's in the chat here. Yenzer, good to see you. He reminds everybody, if you want to play Crackdown, make sure you fire up your 360 and save your game to the cloud.
I didn't do that.
So that when you open it up on the Xbox One, boom, cloud save.
That is a great
tip. So thank you, Yenzer, for that
tip.
Yeah,
because what I wanted to do was nip on last night, climb up the agency tower, the keep, and take a screenshot from the top.
Right.
But obviously when I went in, I hadn't
seen
it.
You have no power.
So
you're mere mortal.
You're
mere mortal. I'm playing that as well. It's a lot of fun. What else you playing?
I know this isn't exactly a hot take, but Ori and the Blind Forest.
Yeah. Really? Tell me more about this.
Oh, mate,
yes.
I have slept on that game so badly.
Really?
When it first came out, obviously all the hype and, you know, worked on it a lot. I was really excited. I maybe played the first hour. For whatever reason, never went back.
Did you get to the tree
yet?
So I did it last night.
Oh,
and
I got
out. Yeah. I got.
All right.
That was the last thing I did last night before
How many
I played
times
Crackdown.
Did it take you?
I would say maybe. Yeah, this is it here, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is this section. It Maybe 10.
Oh, I think I lapped you easily on that. Maybe 20, maybe 30 for me.
Maybe 300.
Yeah, I just kept going.
I was at the point where I was like, I knew I was coming on here today, and I was like, I have to finish this before I go on Larry's show tomorrow. So
and
I just kept
did.
At it.
And you did. Thank
oh,
you
oh, my God,
that.
The feeling when you get out, because you have to chain everything pretty perfectly on the way up that tree, right? When it's the Ginzu tree.
Ginzu tree,
And it's... But that's the thing I love about the game is like, and I never appreciated it when I played it briefly beforehand, is
Look at this.
You get so dialed into those controls and they're so perfect.
Yeah.
Like pixel perfect controls.
Here we go.
That when you start unlocking the abilities and chaining those things together, like the bash and the double jump.
Oh my God.
You look at it, there's parts of the game where I look at it and like, you know what you're supposed to do, and you're like, I'm never going to be able to do that.
But you do
and
it.
And then all of a sudden, your fingers are just like...
I'll just wait.
Oh my God, this is amazing.
So. There's two more sort of set pieces similar to the Ginzu tree that I look forward to
hearing. This is, this is a fantastic... I mean, it's a beautiful game. It's emotional. It's fun.
Yeah,
it's
gorgeous.
Just everything.
And it was one of those random ones on Saturday night. I didn't know what to play. Mm-hmm. I was looking through my list of installed games, and it was there, and I was like, do you know what? I've got an hour. Let's just.
What I love about that game is also, it's an interesting story that we've told in the past, but it's worth repeating, is that this game was developed, distributed.
Yes, it was.
Meaning the team that worked on it, they don't have an office. They're around the world.
Yeah.
So this was really, you know this, Laura, it was globally created and developed and worked from people around the world.
Yeah, Germany and Israel and the United States. And I think
it was
like
a regular United Nations.
Yeah, yeah. It was
which, you know, is incredible when you see how together that game is.
Right, that's what I'm saying. You think of how it doesn't feel... It feels like it was made by one person with a single vision, but man, they just... Anyway.
So I want to apologize to Moon for sleeping on that game for so long. So. But, you know, if you've been daft like me and you haven't played that game, then definitely get on. It's amazing.
Daft means crazy.
And then just to finish up, I've been... daft. On the Gamerscore thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
I kind of came to a realization over Christmas that, like, I've set myself a challenge to get 10,000 additional Gamerscore by the end of the year, right? So it'll get me to 80,000.
Reasonable,
right?
Yeah.
So, and I realized that Xbox Game Pass is like a treasure trove of Gamerscore and achievements. Right? It's beautiful. So I've been dipping into that, picking a few games, you know, making sure I can get some good Gamerscore. And it's been brilliant because I've discovered some stuff that I never got around to playing the first time, and I'm having a blast with, like Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons.
You
I
never
think
played that the first
I
time.
I never played it, I know, and it's like Ori, right? This is one of those games that like I know I was supposed to play, I'm really sad that I didn't.
And some Game Pass, in fact, speaking of Game Pass, some new titles went in.
Yes.
So we talked about that?
These are the March titles.
These are the March titles.
So some of the biggest titles, I think this is easily the biggest month. This will be the first time we have a new... Microsoft Studios released directly going in, and that'll be Sea of Thieves on March 20th. But Rise of the Tomb Raider, obviously huge. Super Lucky's Tale. I got to tell you, Oxenfree is absolutely one of my favorite games from...
That's one of you and I talked about that
one. Did you finish it? 2016.
No, I got stuck right at the end.
You got stuck?
Yeah, I couldn't figure out.
With a decision? Puzzle.
It was a puzzle.
There was some real interest. So it's a game there's not like any like battling per se. It's so creepy.
Yep.
And there are so many endings to that game. That was one of those ones where you beat it, and I'm like, oh, I kind of like how that ended, and then went back to YouTube, and it was like, oh my God, that could have happened, or this horrible thing could have happened.
So now I remember, that was the game where I felt like, for the first time, my decisions actually mattered.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the conversations felt almost real,
mm-hmm.
and the choices that you make, it felt like... It actually
it
mattered
because
there's so many different endings to it. There's so many different paths you can take.
And
it
I think
like
that
matters.
The conversation like engine that they had in there
amazing.
Is better than any game I've ever played. Because at any point, you can interrupt. And that will play into how they feel about you. And there's sometimes where you need to interrupt before someone says the wrong thing or something. So it's really... Man, I love that.
Oxenfree.
Go do it.
In Game Pass. Also, we've got the rest of these in here. Sea of Thieves will be a Game Pass when it launches next month, middle of March.
Mm-hmm.
Very excited about
that. And I've heard good things about Final Station, but I haven't played that one yet.
I got to ask you a question, though. Which is, you know, as a former resident of Europe, what makes Eurofishing European? Because that is in Game Pass.
Yeah, I guess it's all the lakes and waterways are based in Europe.
I don't know.
Some of the best in the world, I would say.
Do we get an appearance from the Loch Ness Monster in the game?
Yes, probably.
Did I just spoil the game?
All the fish have accents.
Yes.
Stuff like that.
Oi, put me back.
That's actually, I spent time with Dovetail that made that game.
Really?
And, what
and
else
like,
did they do?
The train sim game,
which
I think comes out next month.
Cool. Right.
Their whole business is built on these like incredibly hardcore niche simulations. And they, as a business, like totally live it.
Right.
Like, Like awesome. they are staffed with like everyone who's working on the train sim game loves trains, like incredibly loves trains.
The right people to be working
exactly, yeah. And they've got huge audiences and huge communities built around those titles, you know. So
next Gamescom, I think we should go a couple days early and do a little Euro fishing.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
Whatever that is, I'm in.
We're gonna find out.
I'm in. Anyway, so back game pass through for Jeff. Me. Did you talk about what you're playing?
I haven't yet.
We gotta get the rest of the show. We're running. We're
sure.
One thing that I had to finally put to bed. I finished Blood and Wine from The Witcher 3.
Awesome.
I am bereft. There is nothing left inside me. Like, now that I'm done with The Witcher 3, like, I don't know how to move on with the rest of my life. If I could, like, tase the part of my hippocampus that made me remember the Witcher 3 so that I could do it again, I would do that. I would take that.
You're saying you would erase your memory?
That part
again?
Of it, if they can do it that precisely, like, spotless mind.
Just that.
Might forget, like, my kid's birthday.
I'd like that.
Let's be honest, I do that anyway. So, anyway, that game was so good. It cemented itself. It's my favorite game of all
good,
time.
Not only is it good, Jeffrey, it is Xbox One X enhanced.
It is. That's what I was waiting for. So I went and I played it over the course of the last month and a half, Hearts of Stone and Blood and Wine. And these standalones would be Game of the Year contenders. They were that good, like, moved me that much. And the thing specifically about Blood and Wine that really put it above and beyond was like this whole new world, a whole new map that sort of evoked maybe like Southern France or Italy. Everything had a French name, but everyone had an Italian accent. That's fine. It was like Forza Horizon 2, you know? It's like, it's a little bit of, it's the best of both.
A little column A, a little column B.
But there was a whole, there were new monsters. They actually added new components, like ways that you could mutate Geralt. So there was a whole new stuff there. I wanted to do all the side missions. I must have spent probably close to 30 hours just on Blood and Wine. It was just phenomenal. And so after that, I finished that. I was like, well, there's still things I have to jump into. There's probably a million independent games that I've missed since I started getting back into this. So I started playing a couple of games. And the one I want to talk about the most is a game called Samsara. Came out pretty recently. This is an ID at Xbox title. And it is a Xbox Play Anywhere title. So I was actually playing it on my sofa, on my laptop. And it's a sort of a puzzle platformer, if you will, where you're basically just helping a little girl in a hoodie make it from one side of each level to the other by placing blocks in a way that she won't fall. And there's like no crazy hard jumps. It's completely cerebral, but I found it both relaxing and challenging at the same time. So Samsara is a game that I would definitely take a look at. Another one I just want to mention real quick is we've talked about is Okami HD.
Yes.
I finally had the time to sit down and jump into it, and oh my God, it's beautiful. This is an enhanced title. It is a game that I feel like everybody should play. It's from Clover, which was some studio that worked closely with Capcom in the last decade that has amazing people like Kamiya-san and Shinji Mikami and made some just amazing games. I think they might have made Bayonetta as well. Beautiful Joe. Yeah. This was a team just known for making games that had excellent story, but also had visuals to match. And one of the key things here is this celestial brush, where you sort of break the fourth wall and are able to paint these like glyphs onto the screen that actually impact
gameplay.
Look at
the art style in this game.
Like, there's no game that looks like this. No. Like, there's no other way to put it. And it was on sale incredibly affordably very recently. I'd have to check and see what it is right now, but I had picked it up when it first came out on Xbox One in December. Can't recommend this game enough.
You know what? I look at it now, I hadn't thought about this before, but it looks like it's influenced Zelda. You know, Zelda on the Switch.
It is very, like, the gameplay is very Zelda-esque, where I don't have the ability to affect this, and then later, I've gotten there's 13 different brush arts that allow you to do, like, bring things back to life, and all of a sudden, this pathway is now open to me. So there is I would say it's a very Zelda-esque type of experience.
Nice.
I'm looking forward to trying that. It's on my list of things to go play.
Make some time. The first 20 minutes is just a cutscene, so like just let it play out for a bit. But once you get a feel for it, plus the dog's like adorable. I don't even like animals, and Amaterasu is
that's
like,
true. He doesn't.
No, I really
it's
don't.
Really sad.
But this one, if I could adopt a celestial god dog, I would do it.
All right, we're getting close here. It's 29 minutes after the hour, Jeff, just to prove that we are live. We're getting what I'm playing. We kind of talked about everything I'm playing. We talked about PUBG. Still playing a little bit of Overwatch. The Lunar New Year is coming to a close very soon. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's over already. PUBG, playing a lot of Sea of Thieves. We had the scale test, so I've been out on the high seas doing that. Getting my pirate on.
Did you capture any chests?
Oh boy, did we capture chests. Holy cow. Look at this.
What is this?
Look at this great shirt I picked up when I was over at Rare.
Oops.
Sorry, audio guy.
Not compatible with microphones.
Yeah, so this is look at that thing, huh?
That is flashy. That is
pirate gold right there.
Love it.
That is it's almost too much.
What, you brought one back for the whole class, right?
Did not. but thank you for asking.
What's on the back, Larry?
It's basically they got it for their insiders. So see if these
Oh, so if you're an insider, you also got one.
Yep.
Oh, awesome.
That's a good shirt.
That is.
Definitely.
Can't even see it.
So. I would say that's the shirt that more people have asked me to try and get them, one of those shirts,
really?
Than any other like merch shirt I've ever seen in
who
my time at Xbox.
You?
Like Mark, people at agencies and community, and you know that's the
I'm
one.
I'm sure
that
I've asked you
like,
at least once.
Well, there you go. See, Jeff.
In fact, the chat. I'm looking at the Mixer chat right here, and they seem to like it. So that's good. Good for you guys. Anyway, we're gonna roll through the headlines. We've got to name the game. We've got some other cool stuff coming up. So why don't we?
Sure.
Get to that.
Get to the news
some of the
desk.
News to the news
get
desk.
To the news.
Okay, pull down the weather and put up news.
All right. Lennox, we got the videos ready to go. Okay, so actually quite a bit of news and perfect segue with your t-shirt. We have just announced the Xbox One S Sea of Thieves bundle. So if you're like me, we're probably in my house going to be playing on multiple people playing in one crew at the same time. If you need another Xbox,
no,
there
that's
is.
Not this.
It's not that one. Man,
that
I would love
beautiful.
That one.
That we'll talk about that one in
Whoa,
a minute.
Someone must have customed that out. That looks like a Geordie Tommy special.
No, that's actually the Coco one. We'll talk about that one.
Oh, sure.
A
All right. Well, there's that. But there is, and you can check on Xbox Wire. We'll link to it. And it's basically an Xbox One S that that's a 1 terabyte hard drive. And it does come with Sea of Thieves. Some new enhanced titles. I know we've talked about Crackdown.
Yes.
Looking beautiful on Xbox One X. That is not the only one.
There it is.
There's it.
Are she blows.
We're not live. Just edit it out, right? We'll edit that one out from before.
See, if it wasn't live, we would fix it, but it's not, so we can't, and here we are.
Here we are. That's the one. You want that one. So some new Xbox 360 titles, which are new to backward compatibility, but also enhanced. And one of them is, we were talking about Witcher 2, Assassins and Kings. Oh. So that was a game, you might even have it because I want to say a year, maybe 2 years ago, was part of Games with Gold.
Yep.
So you may have it in your library somewhere. It's now backward compatible. I think it may have been backward compatible, but now it's enhanced for Xbox One X.
Can we pull up the console in a minute? Let's see, look who's playing.
What?
Oh, yeah, there we go.
I'm going to have to talk to him. One of my employees is playing with a Witcher 2 Assassins of Kings. So
can you guys
it's
see
Phil
it?
Spencer.
Yep.
Phil Spencer is playing this.
Nice.
I didn't.
Assassins
so
of Kings.
He's actually playing it right
anyway,
now.
Anyway, and I've seen some screenshots on the big fan of the Xbox One subreddit, r/Xbox One. Keep up the good work, guys. They had a great screenshot of showing Geralt from what it looked like on the 360 with what it looks like now. And oh, my
he's
God.
He's buffered like you.
Thanks.
He's aged well as well.
There you go. Yeah. Very good.
He's definitely got more hair than me, though.
Yeah,
I'll say
this
that.
Is,
God bless
very
him.
True.
That's lovely hair he's got.
He's got that silver fox thing going on. Like, yeah. Larry, if you grew your hair out, you would look like Geralt.
Maybe a little, Halloween. Like a little bit longer.
You start now by Halloween.
I need some more scars. Should I internet? Should I do it?
Do a photo shoot of you
if
in
If you ask,
bath.
The answer is going to be yes. Two other titles besides Crackdown that we had mentioned is Fable Anniversary and also the original Forza Horizon. So they've all been enhanced. You may own these games. Go play them, and they've literally never looked better.
Never looked better.
Forza Horizon looks amazing.
We talked about Xbox Game Pass, those games that are going to be coming in March. I have no problem saying that it is the best addition, the best month of additions to Xbox Game Pass ever. New update to, you may have this already again, Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite is now an Xbox Play Anywhere title.
Delightful.
With cross-play, so you can play against someone on Windows 10 versus someone on Xbox. So I got to go check my library. I may have a portable version now.
That's
like
the beautiful
the
thing about it. You open up your Windows
year.
10, and all of a sudden, hey, there's a game.
Exactly.
Very cool.
There it is.
Fun.
I wanted to talk about a few things that are coming out this week.
Please.
This was a very big ID at Xbox release week. And I think you know what title I'm talking about.
That would be, of course.
That would be of course, Immortal Redneck.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
This is a title.
Really?
There's a game called Immortal Redneck, and I was like, That's interesting. I actually got a couple requests for this. A couple people, Blaine, really? Was asking me, like, do you have codes for Immortal Red? And I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, what? And so I looked at the description, and I was like, oh, this makes sense now. Immortal Redneck is an FPS set in Egypt.
Right. That makes sense.
Right. I was like, okay.
Redneck and Egypt. That goes hand in hand.
You have my attention. How the redneck is immortal, got into Egypt, play the game. But that is one of the more... I have to play this game now. There's actually a tips and tricks post on how to survive an immortal redneck, because despite being immortal, apparently you have to survive.
Oh.
There's a lot of questions here, but I'm very interested. I'm very piqued. We're seeing there a look at it. Yeah. It looks like it's pretty fast-paced. Clearly takes place in Egypt.
Maybe you're inside pyramids? Who knows?
Look, you name your title that, you have my attention.
Is the character a stereotypical redneck? Is
that Well, he's in Egypt, so maybe not. Oh. And he's immortal.
There are more questions than we have answers.
And there are.
That's what I'm here.
But you know, I inform you how to answer them.
You decide. So a couple other really games. So Gravel and De Blob 2 are out. It's a racing game, and De Blob was a pretty popular game that came out a few years ago.
I'm sorry, they're claiming in the chat. They're claiming it has Mixer integration. Is that true?
Yeah, cool.
Oh my God.
Yeah, really?
That's great.
All right. Well, now this is something. Let me dig into that while we're doing one of the other segments, and I'll look into it.
All right.
But three titles I really want to call out is really pretty. Titles that are going to appeal to a lot of people here. So one is Deep Rock Galactic. It is part of Xbox Game Previews. So the a type of game where, much like PUBG, your feedback is very welcome as the team.
You're part of the development
to develop
process.
The game. Mm-hmm. But this is a game that is an Xbox Play Anywhere game that is already Xbox One X enhanced. And this is a game that we showed, and I think it made its worldwide debut during our E3 briefing last year. And it looked really interesting for players playing it once as dwarves, like mining. It had like a very, it's a co-op FPS. It looked like some really interesting things happening. There was some. To me, it sort of evoked a little bit of like Left 4 Dead.
Yeah.
And so anyway, I'm very interested in this. It is out now. It actually became available just a couple of hours ago. So Deep Rock Galactic, definitely worth taking a look at, both on, again, Xbox One and on Windows 10.
I've heard good things about it, you know, like there's some good buzz about it.
Yeah.
It looks a wee bit like Left 4 Dead.
Look at
like
this weapon.
Minecraft. Minecraft-y.
Mining. There's a lot going on
here. You remember this from E3, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's what I just said, Larry. We're even now.
It was a cool trailer at E3 as well. It was a good moment.
Yeah, this was a game that like a lot of people. I was looking at who was talking about this. Who was interested in this game? And it was actually like it definitely caught a lot of eyes.
Also, Deep Rock has Mixer integration.
Yeah,
awesome.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
The Mixer team very busy.
And we're giving away codes in the Mixer chat right now.
Oh, good.
To the game. So
nice.
Be cool and, you know. Maybe you'll win.
Mm-hmm. All right, so here's another game I want to talk about. This is something I've been looking forward to, dabbled with on PC a little bit, is Darkest Dungeon. So this is a game that is a sort of a turn-based RPG, but is like where you go in and...
Is that this one right here?
Yeah, that's the one.
Yep.
We have to make like a lot of like interesting...
that looks complicated.
It's definitely not... It is hardcore.
This is like this
you
is
are
like
going to lose. You are going
UI.
To die. But it is a game that is punishing, but I think the type of people who enjoy a game like XCOM and enjoy like tough strategy games are really going to be into this game. So this one also just went live on Xbox One in the store just a couple of hours ago, and I really plan on sinking a number of hours into this game and then probably being like beaten down pretty hard.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. One last game, and I saved this one for last because, Larry, you're going to love this.
And yes. I will love this one, too.
Bridge, Constructor,
Portal.
Yes. Oh, I know. I saw this last night. I was like, whoa.
Oh, my God. So
you and I did that co-op, didn't we? Did we do the whole game co-op?
We did Portal 2 co-op.
We did Portal 2 co-op. I'm sorry. You're right. That's
Bridge, Constructor, Outlook has co-op.
I got to tell you, that was the most humbling experience playing Portal with you, because I'm like, I don't know these puzzles. And Laura's like, doink,
just
doink,
here,
doink, doink, doink.
Do this here.
Okay,
here.
I'll follow you. Do exactly what she says. Shut up.
We hope you get some good achievements,
Thank
too.
You.
Yeah. So as you can see here, it's exactly what you think it is, which is taking Bridge Constructor, like the physics-based, mm-hmm. You're building bridges to try and
it's the game
get
you
get
didn't
across.
Know you wanted, but you have to have.
But with portals, and I cannot wait to play this. I mean... I think the title itself sells the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Bridge Constructor Portal.
What's wrong with that?
Buy now.
Nice to see
buy
something
now.
With Portal on it again, isn't it?
Yeah. I agree.
I like it. It's very surprising, and it takes place in the Aperture Science Enrichment Center. It's
awesome.
So good.
Yeah. Nice.
All right.
All right.
I do owe the audience an apology.
Okay.
I do. I just noticed
it's about
something.
Time.
I just thank you. I just noticed something terrible here. I was on the dashboard and over on the Mixer tab. There's a promotional spot for the show, and it has a dog in it. We do not have a dog during the show today.
Not today.
Is everyone disappointed?
That's what we call
I don't know if you're disappointed, but there we do not have we do not have Pug G with us today. You can see him right there on the in the center, and that's my ugly
people
mug.
Are logging out in droves right now.
Yeah, so I apologize. This is it. This, unfortunately, because Jeff is here, a dog-free show.
Is that why you asked me here? Because you couldn't get the dog?
Well,
was I like second
now that you look at it, I did actually. I did ask him to wear the brown tie, and he came up empty.
Yeah, there's similarities there.
I know, it's uncanny.
So anyway,
there was just one other little piece of news I saw this morning. Well, quite big piece of news that I just wanted to add on. So, new Overwatch character reveal today.
Oh my god, did I miss that?
Yes, you did.
Oh, come on. Why was I going to meet?
You're
going to
pull it up right now.
Yes.
I saw that because we find out most things the way you do, and that's
Is it Torbjorn's daughter? Because that's where the rumors were.
Brigitte? Cool.
Okay, yes. That's where the rumors. I'm finding this out now.
I'm not up on the Swedish pronunciation of.
Oh, very cool. She has a whole origin story. All right, this is going to be good.
She's got a big old shield.
Yeah.
She looks super tough.
Yeah, they had been really teasing hard on twitter.com/playoverwatch.
I didn't see that.
It's
hard to find from just scanning the Twitter feed.
Yeah.
But it looks really interesting.
Oh,
there's
well,
a couple
I, this
videos
is the
there.
27th character.
I wonder if it's Brigitte or I have a my niece's Brigitte. Name is Brigitte.
Brigitte.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Right. So I wonder if it's.
Well, now she's gonna start playing.
She's really excited.
Yeah. Get the chat to give us it phonetically.
Hey,
look at the fan art coming
chat,
in already.
Can you
cool.
can you help us out and let us know? Is it Brigitte? Is it Brigitta? Is it Bridget?
Mm-hmm. And when does she come out?
Yes. The youngest of Torbjorn's daughters.
Look at that shield.
Oh, wow. Great job pulling the... It's much smaller than
we're seeing phonetics say Bridget.
Okay. So I heard that she has like some sort of range closing, like a grappling hook or something, but who the heck knows? She has a rocket flail. She swings in a wide arc in front of her to smash multiple enemies at once, and whip shot, which enables her to fling her flail forward, striking enemies at a distance and knocking them backward.
Mm. All right.
So the internet rumor mill has been really good.
We are, you can check that out. Of course, you can find all this information. You follow me on Twitter at Major Nelson. I have tweets up there and retweets. We'll give you everyone's Twitter handles later on in the show when we're wrapping things up. We only have about 15 minutes left.
Wow, this is going really fast.
With news.
The show blows by quick. But Jeff, you got some more stuff?
No. Just Brigitte is on the PTR, which means she'll probably be showing up relatively soon. This is where Blizzard tests things on some PC server. So I'd imagine in the next couple of weeks, we're going to be playing with Brigitte. All right.
Yes.
Thank you. You really did me a solid. I'm sorry.
You're welcome.
I threw you under the bus earlier.
No, don't worry. I'm used to that.
we're cooking along here. We do name the game. Which is a contest that we do.
Time for Name the Game?
Yeah, it is. I believe it's chat. Is it time? Mixer chat. Is it time for Name the Game? Because I think it is. If the control room's ready, I think
we
are ready.
Yes,
all right. So
chat is ready. Good.
The way it works, we've already given away some stuff in chat. And Laura, why don't you explain how this part of the contest works? Maybe for some new viewers or listeners.
For sure. So we love to give away awesome stuff here on the Major Nelson podcast. Yes. And one way to do that is through a contest called Name the Game.
Yep.
It's a really, really simple contest. It's usually where I play sound clips from a mystery game.
Yep.
And then you just send us email and guess what game that is from. But when we do live podcasts, like today, we sometimes give you video to look as well.
To help.
It's like a little hint. Yeah. So for the people who tune in live, they get an extra incentive to win.
And if you're listening maybe after the show, because I take the audio track and post that in my podcast feed, if you're listening to this and you're like, I need a hint, just go over to my Mixer channel and you can scrub forward and find the video, right?
Exactly. And it helps you out to figure out what game those sounds are from.
Yep.
So we do it every week. And we have one to pay off, I believe. Is that right? Do we have the clip from last time?
Oh, yeah, we have the clip. So if we can get the clip ready in the studio, this is an audio-only clip. This was the last time when we did the show when you were in the studio with us.
We'll
go ahead,
a little bit of it.
Go ahead and play that, and we'll show you what it was or let you hear. All right, so
that was last time's Name the Game, and you could hear that was a difficult one.
That was a difficult one.
So what happens is we get a bunch of emails. Some of them are unfortunately incorrect, but we take the correct ones and we put them in a hat and then draw out a random correct winner and
RNG
award prizes. Yeah, exactly. So there's not actually a physical hat. I've gotten that question before.
Yeah.
We don't have a physical hat. It's a virtual hat. And we pick a random winner. So this week's random winner is Quentin from Flint, Michigan. Congratulations, Quentin. His gamer tag is pretty awesome.
Yes.
It's Jolly Armadillo.
Jolly nice. Armadillo. Quentin, so where's he from? Michigan?
Flint, Michigan.
Flint, Michigan.
Yeah.
Good for him. Hopefully.
Congratulations, Quentin.
Congratulations. Now, if you're tuning in and you're trying to say, wait a minute, I want free prizes. I want free stuff. Laura, we can help him out, right?
We can. Okay. So Quentin is going to win a massive bag of awesomeness.
What?
I'll go through what Quentin
okay,
has won.
Okay, go through that, and then we'll make you a winner.
Give you opportunity to win these awesome prizes. So Quentin, you've won an Xbox Game Pass subscription for 3 months, so you can take advantage of all those awesome games we were talking about before.
All you nice. Can eat.
All you can eat, exactly.
Loads of gamer score.
But we also have tons of games for you as well. We have a copy of Terraria, a copy of Deep Rock Galactic, ooh, which is what Jeff was just talking
fresh
about.
Fresh out of the oven.
We have a copy of Age of Empires, the definitive edition for Windows 10,
yep,
which is an amazing game. So if you get a chance to try that out.
Hello.
Blast from the Past is great. We also have a copy of Metal Gear Survive,
yep,
a copy of Sword Art Online, Fatal Bullets, and a copy of Kingdom Come Deliverance.
Been hearing a lot about that game.
So many games.
So that's not all.
Congratulations.
That's not all, Larry.
That's not all?
I always like to throw something in at the end. We also have a copy of Coco, which is a new Disney Pixar movie now available in my
store. Oh, nice.
Right.
It's a movie. This is pretty cool.
Yeah, because we didn't talk to that Coco console.
We didn't.
Ago, did we? Yeah. But
we
can win that, can't you?
Yeah. Yeah.
That Coco custom console.
Do we have the Coco custom console? I don't remember how you win it.
We should show it because it's gorgeous.
Look at that.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
Yeah, look at that thing. We're giving that away. We're giving that away. I think the Xbox. You guys are giving that away?
Yeah, I think. Well, it's linked on the Xbox Twitter feed. I think you tweeted it yesterday or the day before as well. So
yeah, because Coco's on Microsoft Movies and TV.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Have you seen it?
I haven't seen it yet.
So it's funny, as I remember when we were at the Star Wars screening in December, the I was sitting with the guy who did the sound designer for Star Wars, also is the sound designer for this movie. And he told me.
No big deal.
And it was interesting because I remember he told me, I said, wow, you got to work with Star Wars. That must have been really hard. He's like, oh, no, it was actually a lot of fun. The real hard movie was working on Coco.
Really?
I was like, really? This is hard. Anyway, so, but it's a great film.
I hear amazing things about it.
Yeah.
And I hear it's a proper weepy as well, right?
Yeah, all you need to do is enter for a chance to win. Now, if you want to win that console, you just need to go to CocoXboxSweeps.com.
There you go.
So that's,
there you go.
That's how you get in with that.
All right, can I just say as well, just while we're on that, sorry, I know I'm going in. Did you see the Jordan consoles, custom
Xbox ones
we did? Oh, my God.
Yeah, these were a trio of consoles that matched the re-release of the Air Jordan 3s. There's the cement, the Tinker Hatfield, and the free throw line one.
Yeah.
This was a very popular shoe, and matching it in time for the NBA All-Star game. And there's a really cool unboxing I can link out to in the show notes.
Cousteau did one, didn't he? Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. There's been a few. We work with someone named Jacques Slade.
Here it is, right here on screen.
Yeah. There we go.
Yeah, and, look at that.
Yeah. So
I had all those back in the day.
Did you?
Did you really?
Come on. Yeah. Of course I did.
I have no idea if you're being serious.
No,
right
why
now.
Wouldn't I?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I could.
You gotta grow it though.
I just think of like these kids back in.
I
was in elementary school and we couldn't afford those.
Right.
But Eric Winger could. And don't think I haven't forgotten about it, Eric.
Yeah,
so
Eric.
I'm walking around in like.
In
Target
fairness, Eric Winger sounds pretty cool. I mean, that's a good surname, isn't it?
He was pretty cool.
He had the kicks. He obviously was.
Eric Winger.
I need to go. I think we made a breakthrough here.
Right, sorry about that, Laura.
Sorry, Laura. We totally interrupted you.
That's okay.
Sorry, my fault.
Anyway.
So the chat has reminded me, I actually didn't tell you what game.
Yeah, that was my
fault. Game?
Sorry, chat.
Thanks, chat, keeping us honest. Again, a benefit of doing a show live.
Exactly. I'm sorry. I got super distracted by all the awesome games that Quentin won. But the name the game answer from last time was Albert and Otto.
Yep, Albert and Otto.
Yes. So congratulations to all the people who guessed that correct.
Yep.
And extra congratulations to Quentin, who was our
Flint,
random winner.
From Flint, Michigan. Quentin
all right.
from Clinton.
So now, are we ready for Name the Game? For this week?
Yeah, well, we're doing it a little differently because you can see us. We are going to give
sorry
you
about that,
visual
by the way.
Name the game. So we're going to roll the video. It's about a 30-second video clip from a game. And if you're listening to this audio-only version of the podcast, we're going to give you, obviously, the soundtrack. So if you want a little extra help, then come dig up the VOD.
Right. And reminder, please do not answer in the chat.
Yeah, if you answer in the chat, you'll... bad things will happen.
It's only to your disadvantage to answer it in the chat.
It happens
don't
anyway.
Do it. It's not cool.
Do not... upset Laura. All right, so why don't we go ahead and ready to roll that video?
Yeah, let's roll the video.
All right, if you guys have it ready, go ahead and roll it.
So that was Name the Game for this time.
Ooh,
creepy.
It was super creepy, yeah. Mm. So again, don't answer in the chat. The way that you enter is by sending us email. You can email me at lollipop@xbox.com, nccmajor@xbox.com.
Yes.
And let us know what game that's from.
Yeah.
And I saw in the chat, this is open to anyone worldwide.
Yep.
If you're watching us, if you're hearing our voice from the audio podcast, you can enter and yep. you can win. So good luck to everybody out there.
I can't Jeff. Believe someone put the right title in there, Barbie Horse Adventure. We can't. This is why we can't have nice jokes.
Is that still a punchline?
It's always.
It's always.
Barbie Horse Adventure. There's going to be a whole generation that doesn't get that joke.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay with that,
that made me laugh. Thank you very much, chat. That's very good.
All right. I'm reading the chat right now. If you're just tuning in, we're doing the show. We started about 51 minutes ago, but who's counting? And
you are.
No, I've got the clock here because I got to respect studio time is expensive.
You
people
respect your time.
Their time is expensive.
No,
we've wasted that.
Laura, I owe you some Sea of Thieves time when the game comes
yes,
out. Right?
We should play.
You know, all of us
soon.
Can play. We've got four people. Nice, we can play a four
yes. person. We can have you in.
That'd be great.
Well, that
we never got
the boat.
It going last time.
What's
did
your,
yeah, why can't we do
what's
this?
What's your specialty?
Pretty good at falling off the edge of the ship.
Okay, that's
and then being abandoned.
Okay.
I don't know. I'm a good. What am I good? I'm a good shot. I usually play solo, so I'm like
you can
one,
do it all.
A
you
one
do it
man
all. One man band.
One man wrecking machine.
I like steering though. Steering's the best.
Steering's really fun.
You're gonna have to fight.
Tell me more about your visit to Rare.
Well, first of all, Rare was I had Craig on the show last week.
Yeah.
When Laura was out and Jeff was with me, it's just Craig's a delightful studio, and it's great to see some of the work they're doing. It is, and I tweeted this, and I said it last time, and I'll say it again. It is the single most beautiful studio I've ever been to.
Absolutely.
I've been to a lot of game studios, not all of them, but a lot of them. This is absolutely at the top of the list, and they're just wonderful people too.
So true.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you spent so much time out there when you were living in.
I used
England.
To go up there quite a lot. Yeah.
Did
I
you?
Used to. It was nice to just drive up there and have a couple of meetings and then work from there for the rest of the day because it's so like
chill,
calming.
It's serene.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's
gorgeous.
In
and
field.
I bet if they've got snow. It's going
to
look beautiful.
You're not
going to
be able to see the sheep.
Place. That's right. Yeah.
The sheep everywhere.
It was supposed to snow when we were out there, and I told the camera crew, because this is what you can do. I'm like, guys, I really want to have the sunrise, you know, up in the morning with the snow so we can include that in the pieces. And the sunrise was at like 6:15. So these guys had to get up at like 4 to drive out there and get all set up.
Wow.
And then it was overcast.
Very
and then it was
they're
overcast.
Like, I'll see you after lunch.
Yeah, exactly. They were not pleased. But the videos, we'll have some videos that we shot there. I can't tell you when they're coming out. We know when they're coming out. We'll let you know. They're coming out closer to launch.
Just taking a look at the
maybe we're going to be doing something special for the launch.
There goes the spoilers. A lot of people are asking about you, Graeme. Maybe because you're special. Maybe because people are asking you about Arsene Wenger. They should be asking me about that. Wenger out.
Yeah.
But they're asking about why are you in the U.S. right now? I think they maybe didn't get the message.
Yeah, I've been here for almost 6 months now. Like, I actually live
here.
This is my new home. And yeah, no, I've came out, what, September it was?
Wow.
And now I work in Redmond.
He
in
works,
Xbox
he works,
HQ.
He works, his desk is about 100 feet from mine, and I see him less than I did when you were
working. It's true, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's terrible. Sorry about that. Well, it's busy. I have to actually go to meetings now.
Yeah.
I can't just, you know.
But
sit,
I come up and
see
you. Don't come and see me. I come see you.
That's so true.
Right?
No, you're very good at that.
I want to make sure I see you. But
we just need to Americanize you, take you to a baseball game.
Yeah, well, I'm ready.
Yeah.
Let's go. Let's do it.
Awesome.
I want a hot dog.
Do we have a baseball team here?
Nachos.
Yes.
Yeah, I guess. Whatever else to do.
Laura, I'm just being reminded here. I'm getting some IMs here that apparently, I don't know if it's confirmed, Jolly Armadillo is in the chat.
Oh, nice.
So I don't know if it's just, you know, if it's a dog posing as Jolly Armadillo, because on the internet,
imposter.
Nobody knows.
Yeah, that's true.
But if it is, then I believe it's you.
Yeah,
so.
There is. Yeah. Yeah,
awesome.
Absolutely.
Congratulations, Jolly Armadillo. Great job guessing the game.
Jollier than ever.
Yeah,
he is now you're extra jolly.
Extra jolly Armadillo. We've got a busy few weeks coming up here. I may be in New York for the Sea of Thieves launch.
Cool.
We're working on our PAX East plans in Boston. We're very excited about that. You're welcome to join us if you can make your way to Boston.
Sounds nice. I'd love to do that. Never been before.
Yeah, be careful. It snowed a lot last year.
Well, they moved it. It's like a month later than
it was
very, last year.
Remember how cold it was, Laura? I just remember you coming into the hotel and you were
like
angry as a wet cat.
It was like 10 degrees.
Yeah, it was. It was
Fahrenheit.
Pretty, it was
by the way, Fahrenheit.
Pretty folksy there.
That is really cold.
Can we not move it to San Diego or...
Good suggestion.
Well, there is one. There Hawaii? Is one in Texas in January.
But it's in July.
No, it's in January.
It's in January.
Did they move it to January?
Yeah. It's always been in January.
Oh, okay. I thought it was in July. No. My bad.
You're thinking probably...
RTX, maybe?
Yeah.
That's like maybe that. What you're thinking. Yeah. A couple folks were asking. I tweeted out a few weeks ago about some features I had seen the platform team. So I go over to work on the platform team and talk to them about some of the features that are coming soon to you guys and girls. And I think you'll be really excited. That's all I can say. I don't want to say anything more. Maybe I've said too much because I know there's people watching what I say.
Very closely.
All the time, if that makes any sense. So what are you looking forward to playing in the... we're playing Sea of Thieves, right, guys?
Sea of Thieves. Absolutely. Yeah.
That one should be super fun. I'm pillaging the high seas. See if I can get my cardinal directions correct. See if the compass works.
Well, you know, I saw Joe, because that happened to us, where you were claiming your compass was broken.
Yes.
They added some neat features that I'm sure you picked up on. When you're doing the steps, your controller vibrates.
Yes, it does, mm-hmm. to let you know how many steps that you've made.
They recalibrated all the compasses.
They did. And very good.
Yeah, or you hold your compass out while you're trying to do...
While you're walking.
Steps,
and
you'll really feel that you're taking those paces.
Yeah.
Sorry.
It's okay.
You put makeup on me today, and I talked over you.
It's all right.
I'll show myself
that's
out.
That's off-camera talk.
Jeff, do you have anything more you'd like to share or overshare about
excited.
Your relationship here? Oh, boy. Anyway.
Far Cry 5 as well. I'm excited about Far Cry 5.
Actually, can I talk a little bit about that?
Yeah. Absolutely.
I went down to San Francisco last week, saw Far Cry, got to play Far Cry, saw Boomer. Yes, Jeffrey.
Really?
No, I'm excited.
The dog. Far Cry 5, really excited. It's fully playable in co-op. Jeff and I played Far Cry 4 as much as you could in co-op.
Oh.
Because you had to hit a certain point.
Like 20. When are they putting you back in? Because I felt like you, Pagan Min was like a young Major Nelson. And,
really?
Maybe it's Far Cry 6. You'll be the big bad.
Maybe I'm in it.
Maybe.
What?
Do you know where this one takes place, Laura? This one takes place in Montana.
Okay,
so it's far
pretty
here.
Close.
It's got a little bit. It's got a little bit of a. There's a little bit of redneck action going on in there. You'll hear all about that.
Maybe no immortal.
Are they immortal?
Yeah. So who knows? You'll find out. So
you know, every time, like I bristle every time we say redneck because I watched Ozark recently. It's like a Netflix original series, mm-hmm. and there's an amazing scene in that where the word redneck is used, and
it's uncomfortable.
It does not end well.
No.
So yeah.
No.
So yeah. But yeah. Yeah, it looks great.
Anyway, Far Cry 5 coming to Xbox One X, and I got to say this. I talked with some of the team down at Ubisoft. They said, and I may be talking out of school here, quote, this will be one of the best-looking games on Xbox One X.
All right.
Quote.
Really?
So...
They have some stiff competition.
I know. We saw Assassin's Creed and what happens with... I mean, it's so good-looking.
That comes out pretty soon, too, doesn't it?
That March 27th is Far Cry 5.
Oh wow, we only have a month to clear out our backlogs.
Yeah,
I
cannot wait.
So look at this. Yeah, I guess this may be
it. Looks like it. Now, here's the thing. I mean, I feel like every time there was a component where we were flying, and this even goes back to like Battlefield 3.
Oh, still.
Larry always wants to be the pilot, and
I can't help it.
This is like professional gameplay here. It'd be us flying into that building or something like that.
This comes from my frustrated. I think this is my frustrated desire to be a helicopter pilot.
Yeah.
I've talked about it. I should just go up and get my pilot's license and call it a day, and none of you would ever go up with me again.
No.
I actually don't trust myself to do that.
I definitely would not fly with you in real life. I'm sorry, Larry.
No.
Thank you, Laura.
No, there's no way.
There's been too many accidents.
You don't get to reboot that one.
No.
Yeah. Yep. All right. Well, we are at the end of the hour here. It's been an incredible time for you guys. Thank you for sharing with everyone at home and everybody at home, wherever you are. Thank you for sharing your time with us. Really excited to share some news with you, Jeffrey.
Yes.
Thank you for that. Thank you for the news and weather.
Internet, you need to find
Jeffrey on his weather.
Yes, please.
Wait a minute. Did you have like an on-air name, like you know,
like
Lightning
Stormy,
McQueen or something?
I was trying to think of one earlier. And I was really striking out.
Well, like, because the guy in Miami, like where my folks live, is like Steve Hurricane Schwartz. Oh no, in like Philly,
right?
And I'm like, there's no hurricanes in Philly, for sure. But it just sounds better than like
better.
Steve Schwartz.
That's your name.
Jeff Low Pressure System Rubenstein.
Yep.
With your
there you go. Anyway, so you can follow Jeff on Twitter. Jeff, what's your Twitter handle?
At Jeff Rubenstein.
You can follow Graeme here at
AC Bongos.
Laura.
You can find me on Twitter at Laura Lollipop.
And I'm Larry here of Xbox Live's Major Nelson saying thank you guys. We will talk to you next time. Bye bye, everybody.
Thanks for joining.
Bye.